This is a work of fiction. Any similarity to actual persons, living or dead, or actual events is purely coincidental.
Something doesn't feel right, you know? I don't feel cool enough to be pushing this cart. You know what? I'm gonna give Garrick a call because I want something that's gonna allow me to look cool while I'm pushing this cart. Well, I don't want to push this cart. I want something that can... I want something that can just pull this cart automatically and allow me to pick items that I want. So I'm gonna give Garrick a call.
Hey, Doc.
Hello, Garrick. How you doing? Great. Well, I want a ShopLyfter device that you guys were talking about. Yeah. That autonomous robot? Yeah, I want that. Well, I want to look cool.
Yeah. Yeah, the students are working on the robot that pulls the shopping cart autonomously. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I just looked at their 14th DOS. Terrible. Oh my god, terrible. Yeah, I'm tired of marking these. Maybe just go easy on them in the next one. Thanks.
The assembly for the driving system consists of a steel frame, driving motor, gearbox, an LDA battery, a single wheel, mounts for a servo with two gears to translate a 270-degree rotation into a 90-degree rotation. The tracking system utilizes ultrasonic transducers as a mean to an indoor positioning system, which are mounted on a 3D custom bracket to maximize field of view. The following is an example of the driving system for the ShopLyfter being stress-tested. It is always good to measure the resilience of the device compared with the mathematical model before sending it off for machining. The results of the tests are used to determine whether the material being used has the operational strength to withstand the forces, and to determine the breaking point or the safety usage limit. Once a stress test has been completed and the results are confirmed, the components are then sent off for machining. Here is a footage of Sage, a member of the ShopLyfter group, machining the gearbox. For tracking, each pair of ultrasonic receivers are programmed to detect two different lengths, and then the effective distance and directional angle are calculated based on an angle of arrival algorithm. The distance and direction are then used to control the speed of the motor and angle of the servo to track the user. The group implemented a PID control on the drive motor such that it is sped up as the user goes beyond the following distance of 1 meter. It slows down as the device approaches the user at rest. The feedback for this PID algorithm is the distance of the ultrasonic sensors. The servo motor is programmed to rotate to the specific angle of the user to track him. The group fully optimized the constants and then started assembling the battery, sensors, mounts, belt to the device to make it fully ready for testing. Finally, the results of our testing. We determine a total troubleshoot time of 2 minutes 38 seconds, giving a reliability factor of 0.297. The payload that the device was able to pull was roughly 30 kilograms, resulting in a weight factor of 1.25. The speed during our test was 0.24, giving a speed factor of 0.08. The cost factor added up to 0.847, and the portability summed up to 2.55, giving us a coolness factor of 0.641.
And that's it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.